Okay, good afternoon. Welcome to Mining Investment North America Conference here in Toronto, Canada. So now we have one of our speakers here with us. So I'll let him introduce himself, who he is, and which organization he's from.
Thank you very much. My name is Dmitry Suschov. I invest in mining projects, primarily in the exploration stage. So I take the exploration risk and then take the projects to feasibility study and ultimately to production. So in terms of my background, one of the first deals I made in the mining space was industrial minerals. I sold top quality silica sand mine and silicon carbide production, which was second largest globally after Saint-Gobain, after the French conglomerate. I sold it to Carborundum Universal, the company which is publicly listed in India, part of Murugappa Group. And then I was in different mining projects, in particular recently in the PCI coal, where I built a relatively large producer, started production in 2011, and then gradually developed quite a substantial global market share, selling across Europe, Asia, and even up to Brazil. And now I'm entirely focused on PGM and base metals projects. So I put first project to production in 2016, which started as a joint venture with Anglo American, the largest platinum producer globally. And we started the joint venture in 1999. Then I bought out the English share in 2014, and 2016 put this project to production. And now I'm taking the production second project, which is has Sinosteel state-owned enterprise from China as a partner.
Another area of your expertise would be in blockchain technology. So perhaps you can also share with us what you think is the benefit of blockchain technology, and how does that help to support and impact the mining industry?
Right. So blockchain is definitely a very important technology across different industries. And that's for sure the future of the internet. That's internet is developing in cycles, and we are in a new decentralization cycle. So the internet will be more decentralized, and this is definitely benefiting everybody. And as far as the application of blockchain technology in mining is concerned, we have a number of applications. So one that is quite a major one is related to traceability. So we had a very good presentation on Cobalt today regarding the traceability of the origin of where the cobalt is coming from. It's like you are tracing your own DNA, right?
Yeah,
so
right.
So you know where it's coming from, and that's very important for the consumers because the companies like Tesla's and others that are really concerned about where the raw material is coming from, whether it was legally and ethically mined. So that's where the blockchain comes into play. So you can trace down to the particular mine. Also, what I think is very important is that blockchain allows you to have the investment instruments that are metal-backed, which is very important because you have a number of derivatives nowadays, like ETFs for gold, etc., etc., that allow you to invest in the particular metals without actually having to physically store them. At the same time, those instruments are not metal-backed, like ETFs are pure paper products. So you are wondering where your metal is, it might not exist. So basically what a blockchain allows is to issue tokens that are 100% metal-backed. And that's what we are doing in the PGM space now, in platinum in particular, because there are not so many instruments to invest into platinum bars, for example. And when a private investor wants to buy a platinum bar, he needs to pay much higher price over London. And then if a producer like me is selling the product, I'm selling at a discount to London. So there's a big margin staying with intermediaries. So we're addressing this margin, plus we are reducing transaction cost and storage cost. So investor just buys a token and doesn't need to store the physical product. And there's a number of banks, in particular in Japan, in South Korea, and even in Switzerland, like Swissquote, that are both trading metals, and they're also trading the crypto instruments. So you just open a bank account with Swissquote, and you buy metal, or you buy a token, which you can physically redeem for metal at any time. So basically that allows you to not to be exposed to the wallet risk, to the exchange risk. So you are shifting this risk to the bank. Mm. And at the same time, it allows you not to necessarily buy physical metal and have to store it and incur storage costs and incur transaction costs. You can just keep the token and you can redeem it for metal at any time, at the same bank you bought the token from. So that's how it works. And that allows private investors to buy metal in very small quantities. Plus, it allows crypto hedge funds to diversify their portfolio, because there's a bunch of hedge funds that are now focused on crypto investments and their portfolios are highly correlated. So all the instruments are highly correlated with Bitcoin. So Bitcoin goes up, the whole portfolio goes up. Bitcoin goes down, the whole portfolio goes down. So those portfolios are really not diversified. They're highly correlated. And hedge funds, by their definition, needs to hedge. So the token that is metal-backed allows to diversify because it's not correlated with other crypto, and that creates a hedge for this kind of hedge funds, and they are very interested in this kind of instrument.
Okay, thank you very much, Dmitry, and it's always a pleasure having you here with us. So we look forward to also growing this event further here in Toronto and working with speakers like yourself to help expand this conference here in Toronto as well. So thank you very much, Dmitry.
Thank you.
Thank you.